Once upon a time, a kid wanted to be fame. It's 12 years young, bragging about fake money and how fame is lying through the bare bone of his teeth to all of his friends. He depended on the gullible mentality around him. The young boy had nothing in life, just lies to the brink of the rim to feel the glory. He tried to discover the myth, the legend, find the devil's den, his lake, just for that wish, for the search of it. He threw away all of his friendships. He threw away everything just to be praised. Then the devil emerged. He gambled his life away with the devil's manipulation. Surreal it was. All the money and fame just for a soul done. He agreed. Now the contract has begun. For the first few months, his dream was achieved. His lungs could barely breathe. His eyes could barely see. In his mouth could barely speak. The excitement that he could be finally seen by millions all around the world filled him with greed. At first he would go to public places and pose for paparazzi, go to the mall to get recognized, take photos with fans and give autographs for free. 5-star hotels, alcohol and endless parties, dine with models, red carpets and forced meet and greets. He even started investing to try to gain more money. He played his life risky from the start. He even got to meet with the people he idolized and prayed since he could walk on both feet. He bought mansions, villas with Lamborghinis and Ferraris. Everything seemed in his life to go perfectly momentarily, until the sound of a photo snap from the paparazzi would drive him crazy. His investments in cryptocurrencies lost him loads of money. Fans obsessively stalk him. In a moment's time, he had no more privacy. He was at a point where only drugs gave him his sustainability. That threats and hate from random people made every corner of his life scary. Started excessively drinking, gambling, and wasting the rest of his money. No one loved him. Another washed up and lost celebrity. The devil just lurked in the shadow, watching him having breakdowns mentally. He was crying in despair on the side of the streets. The demons got to his head. Now he's existential about everything. No more compliments from his fans. He was a complete and utter freak. He got lucky and got rehabilitation, a psychiatrist and therapy. Now he was on medication that was prescribed falsely, but the trauma and pain got the best of him. He projected his anger towards everyone surrounding him. Local news started insulting him for assaulting a random man. A young boy with a dream and a forsaken deal became manic and psychopathic. Damn, he had no more money and contemplated overdosing. He was lost in life. He looked crippled and rotten on the outside. He stopped eating. All his bones looked visible when he was starving. He was soulless. You could see it when you looked through his eyes, losing color. The more he was surviving by an inch of a thread. Nevertheless, the devil kept him alive, which had led to him shooting himself in the head. But then he awakes in a bed at the hospital. He was saved from death. The devil wouldn't let him die by his own hands. He continued to beg. He wanted to be a kid again and never asked for the disgusting wish. He was decrepit, his skin decomposing on himself. He wasn't human anymore. Living was torture for his mental health. Now he truly couldn't speak. He mumbled the joy out of his broken mouth. Most of his teeth fell out. This was a reality he couldn't doubt. He went on his last journey to the devil's den, stumbling and tripping on every rock and branch beneath him. He was a few meters away from that lake. Then all of a sudden, he greets the devil as an old friend. He says his last wish and jumps in. The contract was accomplished. He took his own life by drowning. The devil then brought him to the deepest depths under the mountains. Now everyone forgot about that man, even his his parents that loved him. Only I'm here today that witnessed it. The Devil's Lake at its forsaken legend.